very yellow tonight.
It's actually like lime green.
That's
Does it look green. Yellow?
That looks yellow.
Oh, in person it's lime green. Is it bad?
No, it's just like yellow. It's not a bad thing.
Now I'm self-conscious about my hair and my sweater.
Oh, you look fine. Blah. You look fine.
And they don't even have the kitty to hide behind her. I just hold her up and be like, look, I'm a kidder.
She's hiding again, eh?
Well, she's taken to sleeping with my nephew at night.
Mm.
Which, you know, she's his cat, so pretty okay.
You want to go hang out with him? Sure.
He has a little chair at the end of her bed that's just her size, so she kind of curls up in there while he's asleep. So she might show up, she might not. You know, she's mercurial. She's a kitty.
Yeah, it's not like she doesn't get enough sleep.
Yeah.
Poor thing's an insomniac. She never sleeps.
Well, once in a while she's curled up, like, across my neck or across my arm, I move and fuck up her whole program.
Does she give you the death glare when you do that?
Oh, she gets so offended.
Like,
she makes these little offended noises. She's like, I'm like, I'm sorry. I can't feel my arms.
That kind of happens no matter how that whole sleeping arrangement goes. I've had that with people, that whole, your arm goes dead and you're like, what do I do?
Yeah, but with cats, like, you can't reason with a cat.
You sit there going, maybe I should just gnaw it off.
Like, you don't know how many times I've just, like, let myself be uncomfortable for fear of pissing off the cat. Because, like, she sleeps, if I sleep on my side, she sleeps in a little crook behind my knees, and I'm like, I really want to turn over, but the cat's there. I guess I'll just stay like this, because I don't want to piss off the cats.
Tara, you could punt the cat.
But that would make her mad.
So?
I'm Bridget's bitch.
The hell does the cat have on you?
I pretty much do whatever she wants. Why? She has the big eyes. She does the big eyes. She makes little noises. And I'm like, well, all right.
Okay, well, I have the big eyes too, but I won't make the little noises, so I guess I lose. Of course, mine aren't quite as cute as hers. Mine are...
I actually, like, if she blinks at me, I actually hear the little Looney Tunes plink, plink. Sound.
Whereas you're when, like, I do that, people hear the Twilight Zone theme.
You know, like the cute blink sound in every Looney Tunes cartoon?
Yes,
yes. I totally hear it. If she looks at me and blinks, I'm like, oh.
Well, we have a collection of stupid tonight. Some of it's going to make you...
Boy.
I think our first story is going to make you really happy, because it made me kind of happy deep down. I'm like, hey, yay. Especially giving all the horrible news regarding this issue last week. This first story is just sort of like one of those, yes! All right, let's get the intro on. Where are you, intro? There we go. Okay, each week, Catherine and the Radio Dead Air audience go out in the worldwide interwebs, find all sorts of horrible stuff. We're back here for a little segment we like to call What the Fuck Is Wrong With You? And... we're all aware of this, hopefully, by now. There was a hack of iCloud, and hundreds of nude photos of celebrities were stolen and placed on the internet.
Yeah.
This was a douchey thing to do.
Yes.
But someone, somewhere, looked at this douchebaggery and decided, I'm gonna have me some fun with this shit. And whoever did this, I don't know him. I will never know him, but someday I hope to find him and shake his hand, because this, my friends, this is what a hero looks like. Fake links to nude celebrity crash New Zealand internet. New Zealanders keen to...
What were they actually linked to?
I don't know. New Zealanders keen to view hacked photos of naked celebrities are being blamed for a nationwide internet meltdown involving the country's main provider. It is believed a handful of computer users clicked links on Friday evening, believing they would take them to the illicit images, but instead they inadvertently installed a malware triggering, a crippling internet attack. It took the telecommunications giant Spark, the rebranded Telecom Corp, until Sunday to fully repair what it termed a dynamic cyber attack that overloaded its systems, covering more than 600,000 customers. Intimate celebrity photos, blah, 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 blah. Spark tweeted it was aware that when people clicked on some links, they inadvertently installed malware, quote, generating a high amount of traffic to overseas sites. Ha, 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 ha.
Let the punishment fit the crime.
You fuckers. I just take a moment to appreciate this. So many people were so keen to see these people nude. They, number one, clicked on anything. Never do that. Never. Number two, so many of them did it. They brought down New Zealand.
Wow. Those were some lonely hobbits.
Jesus Christ.
I mean, all the elves went into the west. What are they supposed to look at now?
Now you're getting super geeky on us.
I mean, it's the movies. Is that really considered super geeky?
A little.
It's not like I actually read the books.
Now you're losing some points. You gotta read The Hobbit. Read The Hobbit to your nephew.
Actually supposed to read Fellowship of the Ring in high school. It was like 11th grade English. It was an assigned book, and I totally blew it off.
Read The Hobbit to your nephew, at least. You'll both get a kick out of that, I feel sure. But this is... They had it coming! They had it coming!
Yeah, this is basically symbolic retribution. Seriously? Of the Dante flavor.
I mean, okay, there are literally thousands of women on the internet who are perfectly fine with you seeing them nude because that's what they do for a living. They get paid.
Professionally.
Professionally. They have no problem with this. So
they're like, hey, what's up? Look at my boobs.
So why are you so insistent on trying to see the dozen or so who don't want you to see them naked?
And the thing, like, here's the thing I don't really get. Hmm. I looked through years ago a friend's issue of Playboy, and Cindy Crawford was the centerfold. And it was like 16 pictures of Cindy Crawford, and I'm like, how many different ways can you look at the same chick naked? Why do we need 16 pictures as naked Cindy Crawford? Why couldn't we do like two? It's the same tits. And and that's like, I kind of feel like it's just a pair of tits. It's just an ass.
Are you saying you wouldn't require 100 different shots of your sweet babu naked? From 100 different angles.
You know, if there was just one really good one, I'd be cool with it.
Okay, that's fair enough. Fair enough.
Like that opening scene in the Avengers with the close-up of his ass while he's boxing. I'm good. Like, fuck the rest of the movie. I'm good.
Just there is justice sometimes. There is justice because you can't really say, man, that's not fair. I wasn't doing anything. Yes, you were!
Yeah.
Next time, don't go look for this shit.
You only got electrocuted because you stuck your fork in that outlet.
Or in this case, their dick.
Well, hopefully they didn't stick their dick in their computer. Otherwise, there's your problem.
Oh, but they're it's longing. They're longing for the day. They're longing for the day. All right. Do you actually still deposit your checks in person anymore?
No.
Use direct deposit, or I use the my
or
phone.
Or if I get a check, yeah, you take a picture of it. But actually, sometimes I go through the ATM because the phone thing takes like 3 days, and the ATM is instant.
But by
so sometimes I'll actually drive to the ATM and put the check in.
But by and large, it's a practice that's becoming, you know, less. The only time I ever really go to the bank is if there's a problem.
Hmm. I actually, the kind of account I have, I get charged money if I speak to a banker because I have an entirely electronic account.
Well, in this case,
so everything's free as long as I don't want to talk to a person, which I don't.
In this case, they had the money to spare and then some. Boulder police puzzled after woman deposits cocaine at Wells Fargo. Police were called to a Wells Fargo branch in Boulder.
File not found.
Try it again. How is that just worked for me? What the fuck?
Nope.
There. Silly computer. Well, I will just read the story then. It's not a long one. Police were called after a woman tried depositing a wad of cash and a sack of cocaine. She gave the money to the teller and left, said Sergeant Melissa Camp. The teller noticed later there was about a half gram of cocaine in there. Police at the Wells Fargo branch told police that due to privacy laws, they could not provide the woman's name without a search warrant. Camp said that such a small amount of cocaine wasn't worth the trouble, thus the investigation was closed before it could begin. It's just hard to say whether it was money she collected from other people. It was just stacks of different bills. We can't even really confirm she knew the cocaine was in there.
That's not how the safety deposit box works.
No!
Like, you buy a safety deposit box, they give you a key, you go in during bank hours, you put your illegal booty in the box. Yourself. Yeah. You
didn't
don't
you
put
watch
it in the pneumatic tube.
I know, didn't they watch Breaking Bad? That's not how that shit works. You get your lawyer to go in there and put your cocaine in your safety deposit.
You do not put it in the pneumatic tube.
Can I just, I have in my head this image of a woman who goes, I'm so busy today, I'm just going to drop this off here, bye! Just the first thing in my mind, you know, just a huge-ass purse and hair up to here, the big old sunglasses, just, I'm so busy here, just here's the thing, and bye! Lady, you forgot your cocaine. You can keep it.
And she was so pissed when she got home and had no cocaine.
Oh.
So pissed.
But what I love is just like, it's such a small amount of cocaine, they're not going to get a search warrant for the bank is like, nope, we're protecting our customers' privacy and their right to deposit cocaine.
And the cops are like, eh, it was only half a gram. We don't give a fuck.
Eh, sure. It's just half a gram. This just baffles me. It's like, nobody gives a fuck. It's just a thing that happened. And everybody's just
life is really different in Colorado, huh?
Well, you know, everybody's a little more laid back now for some weird reason.
There is that urban legend that, like, all money is coated in a certain percentage of cocaine dust.
Cocaine, yeah.
And fecal matter.
Yeah, cocaine, it's poop and blow. Poop and blow.
Yeah. Which is why I've always said, like, generally, the people that handle your money should not be the same people handling your food in a restaurant setting, because money is disgusting. Like, I've taken money from people that they pulled out of their shoe and it was damp. And that's probably the least offensive place people have shoved money. You know.
Oh. I owe a sack.
I'm sure I've had dudes pay me with, or I've had chicks pay me with the money a horny bachelor party shoved in their ass crack the night before at the club. Like,
you don't want to think about the ass money, though. That's not something you want to think about.
But that's what I'm saying. Like, eating establishments, if they're any good, the person handling your money is not the same person handling your food.
Yeah.
Fast food kind of notwithstanding.
Azash in the channel says, the bank has better privacy policy than iCloud.
Yeah. Just deposit your nude photos at the bank?
Yeah, Wells Fargo. Let's get Wells Fargo to make a cloud storage service because fucking Apple can't do the job.
Just put them in the night deposit box.
That's true.
Physical news.
Which is very funny that, you know, people would be much less more sympathetic if they got stolen from a bank than if they got stolen from a cloud account.
Yeah.
What the fuck? Okay, the next one. Well, speaking of Apple, hey, got a nice little segue. Oh, for fuck's sake. Tara, when was the last time you got an iPhone? Because I know you use them.
Yeah, I'm actually way overdue for an upgrade. I have the iPhone 4.
Now, when you got your iPhone 4.
My top button doesn't work anymore. I have a bunch of messages right now. It's way out of date. It keeps crashing into apps. I'm waiting for the 6 so I can upgrade to the 5 because it'll be cheaper.
Okay, but when you got your iPhone 4, did you stand in line?
No.
That's right. You're just like,
I'm always a model behind because it's cheaper. And because I think standing in line for a phone is stupid. It's a phone.
Well, guess what?
Are they already in line?
Yup.
Like, the damn thing doesn't even technically exist yet.
That's the thing. Apple fans queue up weeks before next iPhone launch. This is from Washington State.
Do you know what that's called? Loitering. That's a crime.
Some 10 days before the reported release, a queue began to be formed in the city that never sleeps to grab the first... Oh, this is New York, I guess. Grab the first retail sale of iPhone 6.
But it's Dateline Washington. This is just...
Well, it's an Indian paper.
It's Times of India, so they just kind of got their...
Yeah.
...lines mixed up, that's all.
Half a dozen loyalists, publicists, rent-a-place professionals, queue buddies have already lined up in front of the Apple Store, attracting attention of TV crews, tourists, and tech troopers too busy to line up but awaiting the first look at the gizmo. Now, here's the thing Apple has announced it will be, hosting a special event on September 9th without specifying details, but the general assumption is it will be releasing the next generation iPhone 6, possibly one or two other gadget snaps, including the iWatch and iWallet. The Apple website features a countdown to the date and the teaser that reads, "We wish we could say more." First off,
do you know what would delight me so much?
What?
If they come out tomorrow and are like, okay, this is a big announcement. Fuck you, we got nothing.
I'm pretty sure they're releasing...
We just wanted to see what you assholes would do.
In the terms of the release cycle, the iPhone 5S was this year already, right?
No, 5C and 5S came out at the same time. Because 5C is like the cheaper one that's plastic.
When did those hit? Last year? Last year?
I think last year.
Well, I guess we're probably close to it. But
I'm a really bad Mac user because I don't fuck about the launch dates. And I'm still using an iMac that's 4 years old. And I'm a loyal Mac user, but I'm kind of a shitty... I'm not a great hipster Mac user because I'm like, oh, yeah, there's a new phone. I hear that's cool. Mine is two versions back.
But it is entirely possible that all they release... is the iWatch, because that's pretty much...
Which would be amazing, because people will lose their fucking minds.
Yeah, because no one... Okay, Samsung tried this. No one wanted the fucking watch. No one wants the fucking watch. I don't care if Apple, whoever released it, no one wants the fucking watch. But even tomorrow, if Apple was to release the iPhone 6 on Tuesday, it'll be more than a week before it becomes available in retail stores. So even if they say tomorrow, it's the iPhone 6, you're waiting in line for a week for phone.
Yeah. And at the end of the day, it's still just a fucking phone.
It's just a phone!
That you can buy 2 weeks later without having to go camping. That's what I don't understand. Like, you can just wait a week and get it then.
Right! It's not like they're going to run out.
And not have had to pee in a bottle.
That's... Like, yeah, you know,
The thing is, especially with any new product that Mac introduces, you want to wait like 6 months. You want the second version.
Yeah.
Because the first version is always kind of fucked up somehow.
Yes. Like,
there's always bugs. There's always shit that goes sideways that they don't anticipate. So you want like the 2.0 or the 1.1 or whatever.
Yeah.
You don't want to be the first one to get it because it's always a little focaccia, you know, like. I don't know why I just said focaccia. That's kind of bread, but whatever. It's never 100%. So you want the next one that they quietly release with apologies.
Apple never like, apologizes.
That never happened. Here's the new one.
Right. See, they don't, they act like it's like the memory hole. It's like it never happened. It was always this one. We've always been at war with East Asia.
Eurasia.
East Asia. Eurasia?
Eurasia.
Oceania. Oh, fuck. I haven't read 1984 in too far. Yeah, I say, oh, I haven't read forever. Man, half of you motherfuckers watching ain't ever read the fucking thing.
Half of them were, like, born 10 years later.
Animal Farm
when that story takes place.
Is that like crackers? I like crackers. I like animal crackers. Now
we're babysitters.
Yeah. Now with the other thing about this, when the Star Wars prequels first came out, yes, they sucked. Okay.
That's the word I was looking for. Thank you, Michael.
The Phantom Menace sucked. But I could understand people lining up.
I had a dream about that last night, actually. And I haven't seen that movie in years.
You had a dream the Phantom Menace sucked? Well, it's no, the reality.
I had a dream. It was part of a much larger dream that had a lot more pathos. But there was a bit in the middle where, like, me and Padme and my nieces were on this, like, boat going through, like, this icy river. And we had to hide from the Empire. So every now and then we'd have to go underwater. We could breathe underwater so we could just hang out down there forever. And then we had to, like, win some dance-off video game to get to the snow-covered mountain where we had to get to the secret room where Yoda was. But Yoda was a robot that we had to reboot.
The fuck? What is even the fuck?
My brain's a weird place.
What just happened?
And we had to stop Anakin from becoming Vader. We had to stop him from putting on the cloak, because if he put on the cloak, he was going to become Vader. And that wasn't even the craziest part of that dream.
My point is, I could understand people lining up for that, because it was a social event. It was a movie. It was a one-time big deal, and everybody was together. It was a big celebration. But it's a phone! You line up with everybody else, you get your phone, then what do?
You go home and play with your phone.
By yourself!
Yes.
You've got your phone, you're done!
You're still freaking out over my weird dream.
Yeah. Oh, okay, our next one is South Carolina, which I always feel the need to apologize for, even though I don't live there anymore, I still need... feel the need to apologize for this. You know how we keep making that joke that when you try and get away from the police and you go home, it's not home base?
Yes.
They're watching my fucking show, Tara. They're watching the fucking show. Look at this shit.
Probability suggests that some of them are by this point.
Fort Mill man calls base on police after car chase. Robert Charles Lafferty, 36, of Fort Mill, was arrested and charged with several driving violations despite his claim to be, quote, on base after leading sheriff's deputies on a car chase back to his house.
I love him. Is he single?
Deputies.
He sounds charming.
Deputies say they observed Lafferty's car drift over the center line on Starlight Drive several times. And he continued on even after deputies activated their lights and sirens in an attempt to stop him. After several minutes, the SUV came to stop in Lafferty's driveway. The driver then reportedly disobeyed instructions to stay in the car and instead walking toward his home's front door. When told he was under arrest, Lafferty said, quote, "You can't! I'm on base!" and reached out with his hands to the side of the house.
Oh my god. This can't be real.
Is this
The Onion?
Nope. This is real.
This can't be for real. Nobody's that stupid, are they?
Lafferty reportedly struggled with deputies when they attempted to handcuff him and, quote, continued to state that he was at his house and could not be arrested.
Oh, but you can. You can be arrested anytime. That's, I mean, good try, though. If you got a particularly dumb cop, maybe they'd be like, fuck. Next time.
You think one of the cops are going, wait, can he do that? No! Damn it, Bob, he can't do that. Have you read the book?
Did you see the remake of 21 Jump Street?
No.
I could see the Channing Tatum character falling for that. Just being like, fuck. I'm watching you, Lafferty.
This is why you're never passing the detective exam. I mean, just, it's, yeah, people are like, this isn't baseball or GTA. Your ass is still arrested. Yeah, because in Grand Theft Auto, you steal a car, you fucking drive over half the town, you shoot down a helicopter, you get back to your place, and you're free. They can't get you.
Really?
Yes.
Is that true?
Yep. Once you get back to your base in the game, your wanted rating goes away and you're fine.
Well, there's your problem.
We're teaching the wrong things. This is what our kids are learning today. They're learning that if you, you know,
if you get home,
you're safe.
Your record is expunged.
This, Tara, this was a joke we would make, okay?
What a world it would be if that was true. If you could just go out and do anything you fucking want, but as long as you can get home before they catch you, it's all good.
Every time someone would go to their house after one of these things, we'd have to joke. It's not home base. This fucker doesn't. It's.
Which one of you was it?
Seriously.
Fess up.
It was one of you sons of bitches out there did this shit.
Which one of you was it?
You just had to get on the show somehow, didn't you? Okay.
There's someone out there that's been like, I've been making really clever jokes in the chat for years and they won't read them. I'll show them.
Our next two stories, the first one's going to make you mad. The second one is going to make you. Well, actually, the last story tonight filled me with hope and joy in a great way.
So it's probably going to make me mad.
Maybe. I know this one's going to piss you off. I keep saying, you remember how we had a story? I have to do it again. Remember how we had a story a little while back where the guy claimed his dog drove him to the store?
Yes.
It's not, it's a dog. Well, someone made it worse. Police say drunk Vermont woman had child drive car.
Oh.
Vermont woman has been arrested after police said she had a child drive her car while she was drunk. 42-year-old Jessica Mathau of Brattleboro was arrested Saturday evening and charged with child endangerment. State police say a trooper noticed a car parked in the middle of the road. Upon speaking with the occupants, discovered that a child had been driving while Mathau rode in the passenger seat. Police say Mathau was highly intoxicated and during her travels had activated the car's emergency brake numerous times in the middle of traffic. Child's age was unavailable.
Not a viable designated driver.
And, WC Wit in the channel points out, her child or a child?
That's an important distinction.
That's a big important distinction.
Like, did she just pick up a child off the street and say, drive me home? Because it doesn't specify that it's her child.
Star Platinum, when the Beatles sang, baby, you can drive my car, that's not what they meant.
God, it really doesn't specify that she had any relation to this child.
Nope, doesn't say how old the kid was or anything, but just... Sir, I need to see your license and... I give up.
Let me give them your binky.
Just can you imagine the cop just be like, I'm out. Done. I give the fuck up. I have seen enough to know I have seen too much.
I have a cousin who's a cop on Long Island, and I saw him this weekend, and he was telling me stories of people he's pulled over, and just, like, the shit people pull, man. Like,
how how drunk are you when this starts to sound like a good idea? How many shots into the night?
That's a lot of shots. And where did you get this child? If it was your child, why were you drinking to that level of excess when you had to get your child home?
Or were you like cruising the Toys R Us? Be like, hey, who wants to drive me home? Like one 10-year-old in the back be like, boom, I'm in there.
Some kid was like, my nephew would do that in a second. He'd be like, okay.
Okay.
Give me them keys.
I also love how she kept pulling the emergency brake while they were driving. What was she doing? She's like, hey, let me show you a trick. We're going to go real fast. We'll take this corner. Like, watch. This is going to be cool. No.
Well, depending on what kind of emergency brake, maybe she thought she was doing something else.
Oh.
Because I used to have that kind of emergency brake. I'm here to tell you it feels a little awkward. I don't know where the emergency brake is on my new car.
I think that may be a good thing.
I should figure that out.
But our last one tonight.
I'm still working out the headlights. I always forget to turn on the headlights.
Yours aren't automatic.
No, and it weirds me out because on my crusty old Buick they were. So I drive around half the time with no headlights because I forget.
Oh, God. Well, our last story, while that was potentially a tragedy, this next story fills me with hope and joy, and I have a good feeling about this one. It comes from Canada, which is the place where joy comes from. All the joy in the world comes from Canada.
Really?
It's the happiest place on Earth.
I was not aware.
It really is.
Okay.
Ask Rob Ford. This comes from Saskatoon. Boy 9 steals Saskatoon city bus, hits 2 parked vehicles. No injuries are reported after a 9-year-old boy stole a city bus and managed to drive
in his pajamas.
In his pajamas.
I heard this on the radio this morning, and they specified that he was in his pajamas.
Police say
he had to stand up because he couldn't reach the pedal.
Police say the bus was stolen from the bus garages on the 300 block of 24th West Street West. CBC reporter Steve Pascalato was driving south toward downtown when he looked over and saw the child at the wheel of the bus. That must be an amazing feeling.
Can you imagine? You're just like, oh, it's going to be that kind of day.
You're driving along. You're like,
oh, I should have stayed the fuck in bed.
That's one of those moments you have to wonder, did I just go crazy?
Have I stumbled into a David Lynch movie?
Another witness, Michael Pritchard, said he saw the boy take the bus and followed him. I just thought, follow the bus and try to stop it. Boy eventually stopped at the corner of Idlewild Drive, 25th Street, after getting the bus hung up on the curb. That's when Pritchard opened the doors and pulled the boy out of the bus and waited for authorities to arrive. When he stopped, I kind of pulled in front and got out so he couldn't go nowhere. Then I told him, get out the bus! Police say the boy hit 2 vehicles, a parked city bus and another parked car, but no one was hurt. Since the boy is 9 years old, police cannot lay charges.
Well, and the reason he took it, they just left the bus running with the doors open.
Yep!
So
that was like, a kid! Alright.
Free bus.
That's one
like
of those...
if you're 9 years old... and you just see a bus with the doors open and the engine running, every kid's going to think about it.
You're sitting there going, I'll get in trouble, but...
but it's going to be so worth it!
Yeah, this is what... you know what? This is what... I can't even fault the kid for it. It's like...
No! Any kid would at least entertain the notion.
It's like, dude, you earned that one. That's all. That ain't on you, man. That is not on you.
There is no 9-year-old in the world that wouldn't at least consider it.
Shinemi just said in the channel, this kid is going to be the king of his school.
Totally.
Yes.
O'Doyle rules!
O'Doyle, yes!
The kid's the king of his elementary school right now.
Let's all ride the bus, eh? Now, it would have been worse if he'd stopped and started picking up passengers.
Now, everybody, we're going to talk about what we did on our summer vacation. Let's start with Billy.
I stole a bus!
It was awesome! Nobody wants to go after Billy.
I went to the beach and I found a seashell. Oh, yeah, I stole a bus!
It's the new I'm on a boat. Take a good hard look at the motherfucking bus.
Oh my god, I love it. If you look real close at the picture, you see he cracked the fucking windshield. This is why you don't show your kids speed. He's like, oh no, if I don't go at 60 miles an hour, that bus is gonna explode. I'ma save the world. I'm Keanu.
Well, you also don't want your kids to aspire to be action movie Keanu.
No. No. That kid is amazing. Okay, Annie in the channel says, bet you that kid was more on time than actual bus drivers.
He kind of was playing GTA.
He was! That's the other thing. You know, you gotta worry. I'm not worried about video games giving people the idea to go out and shoot people.
No.
But I gotta tell you, even myself, after playing shit like Grand Theft Auto and Watch Dogs, I'll sit at a stoplight and have that running in my head and be like, okay, now I get out and I can go take that sports car right now. Mm-hmm. And that's only a 1-star wanted level, so I can get away from that.
This is why you don't let your kid play GTA. Not because they're gonna murder hookers for money.
No, they're gonna steal the fucking car.
Because they're going to see a running bus and be like, it's on.
GTA, the new YOLO. This is Grand Theft Auto Canada. You know, it's not running around smashing into things, killing people. It's a guy gets in a bus and takes it for 2 blocks and be like, oh, I'm sorry there. I didn't mean to hit you.
He did smash things.
He did.
He didn't hurt anybody. Thank God he's okay. Because the story I heard on the radio said that he was standing at the wheel.
Yeah.
He couldn't sit and touch the pedals.
So he had to stand up.
If he hit something, this kid would have been seriously fucked up. Like if he hit something head on or whatever. So thank God everybody is okay. And that's why this is funny.
Did they name him anywhere in the article? I don't think they did.
No, he's a minor. They won't.
Well, kid, if you ever watch this someday, if someday you ever
browse... watching it now... call CPS.
Yeah, but if in the years to come, if somewhere along the line on the internet, maybe archive.org or something, you find this about you when you were 9 and you stole the bus. Do you ever know that you're my hero? You're everything I would like to be. Because goddamn, that's one of those moments in life, you don't get that again.
Yeah, my nephew's 9, and he knows that Aunt Tara does a web show after his bedtime, and he keeps asking if he can be on it. And I'm like, yeah, it's not appropriate for you.
Uh-oh.
And he can't wrap his head around what Aunt Tara could be doing. That
saying
he can't be a part of.
All of the bad words.
Like, he can't figure it out. Like, well, what's so bad? You're Aunt Tara. What could you be doing? And I'm like...
when he's, like, 15, he's gonna be like, oh...
she's so much cooler than I even knew.
My aunt is the coolest fucking aunt. Oh, yeah? What does your aunt do? She says, fuck on the internet. She's awesome.
And makes Big Lebowski jokes.
About vaginas.
Lots of puns. Yeah.
Jesus. Everybody...
he really wants to be on the show, and I'm like, no,
no,
you can't.
No.
And he knows his cat's on the show, so he's kind of jealous. And he's like, Bridget's only a year old. I'm like, yeah, she's a cat. She doesn't
understand what fuck means. She doesn't care what fuck means.
I can't really morally corrupt the cat.
I guess,
I kind of have a secret identity, I guess.
Well, the first thing we learn tonight is sometimes in life, very rare occasions, you gotta go for it.
YOLO.
Sometimes, but be very certain. Think it through. Go for it. Sometimes.
go for it is a sometimes food.
We've learned that designated driver is good. Designated driver who can't see over the steering wheel, not so good.
And isn't it interesting? We had like the yin and yang of children driving.
Yes, we had this we approve of, this we don't. Don't
I mean,
do
really,
this.
We don't approve of any children driving.
Especially
before the internet offense squad comes and gets us. Like,
no, fuck it. That kid's awesome. I love him. They get all pissed at me all they want. That kid's the best kid ever. No, but this one, you know, and also not your kid, not anyone else's kid, no kid. Because the story doesn't distinguish if it was hers or not. Don't just go find a kid and have him drive you home.
Don't just go find a kid and have him anything.
No!
Just leave children you don't know alone unless they're on fire.
We've learned the only places in the world where I'm on base will get you out of trouble is some sort of schoolyard game or professional baseball.
But you know, you may as well give it a try, right?
It might work.
You're already caught. What have you got to lose?
Maybe they'll fall for that shit. You don't know. It all depends on how
Channing Tatum.
Yeah, it all depends on how dumb your cop is. We've learned that there are many things in life that, you know, it'd be cool to line up for. Like a really amazing concert or a movie that's only ever going to come around once in your lifetime. Not a phone!
No.
It's a phone!
And the thing, like, it's really not going to be all that radically different from this motherfucker right here. It's going to have a bigger screen. It's going to have more memory. Maybe Siri will work.
No. Come on, Tara. That's just crazy talk.
But, like, it's not going to have a fleshlight attachment, although there is one for the iPad.
Right.
Now.
Those don't come standard. You right. need to like, get in line at the other store.
It's not going to jerk you off. It's not going to make you a sandwich. It's not going to fill that void in your soul. It's just a fucking phone.
We've learned.
It's going to call people and text and run silly little time-wasting apps that keep you from having to interact with humans.
We've learned there are many things you can deposit at a bank, but there are ways to go about it.
Yeah.
Especially when that thing is cocaine.
Yeah.
Although, goddammit, now I'm wondering how many bank robbers break into a bank and they yank all the safe deposit boxes and are like, there's a lot of cocaine in here!
Yeah, that seems like untapped potential, doesn't it?
Yeah! I wonder how many
safe... Think about the shit that's probably in safe deposit boxes.
Now I understand it. Now I know why people are trying to find new drugs. Because all the old ones are in safe deposit boxes. Nobody can get at them. They're all in the bank. Nobody can get at them.
They're all at Wells Fargo.
Tomorrow we're going to read a story about Keith Richards breaking into a Wells Fargo. And finally this week we learned that if you do attempt to do something like see people naked who really would rather not have you see them naked, you deserve whatever you get, you little fuck. Even if it is crashing the internet of an entire country.
Yeah.
Jesus Christ. Is that all you had? Could you just not fapt anything else? That you had, absolutely had, to see Jennifer Lawrence nude before you could...
The internet is filled.
Yes!
With tits.
Even when you don't want there to be tits on the internet, they will show up. Especially when you don't want them, because then you're doing something your other people are watching. That's not when you want the tits.
But they're there. Tits aplenty. Tits of every shape and size. Tits doing everything you can possibly imagine them doing.
My taxes?